seven, eight. You're the fire and the flood.
Once you're out on the stage, it's like all your worries are gone and all you can focus on is the crowd.
It was the most nerve-wracking experience of my life.
I was like very nervous. I'm talking to a lot of people, I'm very jittery, but it's so worth it.
Because this is one of the last times I'm gonna be able to dance with everyone.
And sort of helps you remember that you can't control anything in life.
I've found that it really is a passion of mine.
Yes, ma'am.
The show always goes on. It can never go off.
Everything's back to normal. It's like a sandwich. It's freshman year, senior year, and then COVID in between. But I love topping it off with my senior year being normal again.
The first season of Pacesetters is football season, where we perform at football games, the halftime shows.
We prepare for football season by attending a Showtime camp, which is a three-day camp where we spend the night and we learn multiple dances. So that's where we get some of our dances from.
We get to do pep rallies on the days we have games, which is so much fun.
Pretty fast pace. You learn a dance and then you try out that week and then you perform it the next week, all while having to remember the dance that you're performing the week of.
Currently, we are working on dances for next week.
I just loved Fridays and knowing that we'd be having a game that day. I love the away games since we didn't get to experience those last year. And this year was kind of like my first experience really having that. And it was also really fun being on leadership doing that. I really loved, you know, I love doing fight song with everyone, doing the stand dances and performing.
We have morning practice this year, so it wasn't like, oh, we have to wake up so early for Friday morning practice, because we were always waking up early. We would stay out there longer from morning practices though, and it was on the concrete. So that was a change from before.
Don't worry.
Hey, how we feeling?
How you feeling?
Hot.
Yes.
How we feeling?
And I didn't even learn what mom said.
It's the most fun. It's really busy and a little bit hectic because you're learning sometimes two dances a week, but it's like, I mean, you get to perform so much and there's so many opportunities to get to perform, and like you're kind of testing your ability to like learn a dance and try out in such a short amount of time. And so it's like, you just like really have to test yourself, but it's really rewarding. And I love going to the football games with the team and getting to cheer for the football team, and just like that whole like Friday Night Lights is so much fun.
Football season was one of my favorite seasons so far because it was something new every week, and learning new dances every week, every other week was really hard, but it was something to look forward to at the end of every week. And being surrounded by everyone at a football game was so much fun, and seeing all the football players. It was really fun to perform at halftime. And performing in front of a crowd is so much fun, and it's so much more different on the field than it is on a stage.
The moments after our last game as Pacesetters were really special. We all, the seniors, went down to the field and we just kind of laid there and cried together. And it was It was sad, but it was really bittersweet. It was a really good way to like end off our last football season.
I do love football season with my whole heart. Favorite season.
About December, January, we get ready for competitions. In February, we compete two competitions. This year, we competed at McKinney Boyd, which we usually do. And then this year, we got to compete in Hawaii. So it was really exciting.
Dances, and we get an outside choreographer to give them to us, and then we get to learn that, and it's a lot of hard work because we have to get these dances perfected and perfect. And even though it takes a lot of time and effort, it's always worth it in the end because we're really good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 6, 7, 8, 8.
Make sure everyone that's side back, not back back. Don't forget that turns. Hey.
Our POM, our military, our jazz, and our novelty are production. And we clean the dances, and it can be pretty tiring, but we usually just uplift each other.
You'd think it'd be less stressful because it's like it's just the same four dances, but there's definitely that like stress of, you know, you want to get it right, but it's really nice to just focus on the dances for the competition. And competition, I think, is really fun, getting to like watch all the other teams' dances too and seeing everyone's solos. It's really nice and fun.
Season, we learn four competition dances, try out for all of them, and then if you make it, you're in the dance. If you're not, you're not.
This audition season was very stressful. Cleaning dances was very stressful, but competing was so much fun.
No spacing for POM. Like, we didn't even get to practice it in that practice gym. Like, we just sprinted in there. Oh my gosh, that was terrifying. But we did good. We did really good, but it was really scary. We got third best of the best at McKinney Boyd Showtime. Hashtag, we are best of the best. Ignite.
And then we got to go to Hawaii, which I thought was so cool, but it was just a little bit crazy because it was like Hawaii and new team practice and, I mean, new team tryouts. And then we had to get ready for Hawaii, but I think it was just a great learning experience. And then we went to Hawaii, and then we weren't there for the contest. I will say that. We did not come for the contest. We came for Hawaii, and we did what we needed to do, and we got awards. So I think that's what mattered.
Mr. Boswell, your goal. Second runner-up, Wiley Myrick, Pacesetter.
This world record has been achieved. You know the roof on fire. We're going to put in the middle of the agenda with the day. It's something like a roof on fire. I'm on fire. I'm on fire.
That's so cute.
Hold on. It's on the next one right there. Can you see it, Mel?
Oh, yes, I do. Right there.
No.
Do you see, like, the
no.
Ratings?
No.
Is there a way down?
Yes.
Okay. You go down that same way.
Yeah.
Competition season was very challenging but very rewarding because all of our hard work paid off.
So Saturday practice is when we come, normally the Saturday before spring show, but sometimes it's 2 weeks before, and it's normally our first time on the stage as a team.
The stage is new, so there won't be like splinters or anything, and it's really nice to turn on.
So we get spacing for all of the dances. We run every single dance that's gonna be in the show. Normally we have like 15 minutes to get everything done, and I feel like that's when the idea of spring show really hits you, because that's when you're realizing like things need work and this is happening on stage in front of people. But it helps a lot for us to prepare.
So Saturday practice, I was mic'd up. I honestly cannot remember anything I said. So at banquet, when I watch this, it's gonna be a surprise.
I need to tell her what I'm naming my kid.
Tell her.
Nevaeh Blue. And she's gonna go by Navy.
Ooh.
Do you like it?
Nevaeh? It could be like
her husband.
It could be like
me.
Like how I'm like, I just don't like it.
If he didn't like it, like I would divorce.
Right on the spot.
Like, that's this true. Name like is happening. Thing.
Like, when you find him, you're like, how do you feel about this name? Okay. Now like, I need to know.
That's my deal breaker, yes!
Not yeah. Like, what's your name? Like, how are you?
No. How do you feel about this name?
How do you feel about Nevaeh? Yeah.
I love it, but like, what would my last name be? Like, it has to be a good last name.
Okay, oh, so not like... Johnson.
Nevaeh Blue Johnson. That sounds good.
Oh, that's actually not that bad.
Must well, I don't want to marry AJ, obviously. You're gonna... did the music work? Is it working?
The experiences that you have are wild. Wild.
Dun, dun, dun. I was only walking through your neighborhood, saw your light on, honey, in the dark. I said, anywhere you go, where you are. Sorry, I didn't touch you. Anywhere you go, where you are.
But normally you'd have your Saturday all-day practice, and that goes usually from like 8 o'clock to 6 o'clock. And you run through the whole show, that way we have an idea. You just kind of go through every dance for like 15 minutes, 45 minutes at a time.
Not from that tiny trip, but is there any way y'all can like scoot back?
I want you to stop in the line you make. We're being so productive. We knocked out all of our team dances except for one that we have extra time for later. So we did all of that, and it worked out a lot better than I thought it was going to be. I did like a new little strategy with telling them how to come on and stuff, so it's working out great.
They look like they're human sacrificing.
Wrap, make sure you wrap your arms, guys.
Yes, ma'am.
It's not you.
So when we were practicing senior at the end of the day, Landry fell. So, and I think we got it on video.
That's how it looks, guys.
Do you need me to play it?
Sure. Actually, no, I got it. It's okay. You do your things. Okay.
Yeah, I got really tired during Saturday practice, and I was stretching. I just fell down. It was kind of sad, but it was a good break, my 2 seconds on the floor. Come on, show them why.
I think Spring Show is going to go so good. We worked on opener the other day, and I wasn't expecting it to be like great because we hadn't worked on it a lot, but we spent one day drilling it, and it already looks so much better, and I'm just so excited for my parents to see too, because they haven't seen any dances so far, so I'm really excited. I think it's going to go really good. Yeah? No? Yes.
Yeah, I think we should change the squad costumes.
I don't think we should. I like
I
them.
I think we should. We don't know, like, we don't know the sizes. We don't know if we have enough.
But I check them.
Yeah, but like, spring show is like 2 weeks away, Whitney.
It's okay. It's okay. We can do it.
Whitney, that's like a little. Take the skirts too.
No, like, we can take. We'll take them back. It's fine.
I think like they're being used.
What if people are already?
The fight with Camilla and Whitney was so not staged. I forgot whose back I was on. I think I had Whitney's back, but like, that fight was intense, man. Like, things were getting heated, I might say. Ignite, flame, it was getting heated up in that auditorium.
Using them in there to check out the top. Can't take them back.
No, it'll literally be fine.
It's gonna be okay.
Yeah.
You can't take costumes back.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, you can. Well, it's really easy.
They don't need them. Why don't we just take them?
It depends on who's in them first.
But they don't need them.
How do you know that? Aren't they using costumes on you?
No.
They've done that before.
It's okay. It'll be fine. It's fine. We can share.
I love Whitney even when we fight.
Overall, the day went really well. We actually got out early, so yeah. Spring Show Tech Week, and we are practicing in the auditorium. It's the week of the show. So Monday, we go in, and we run the whole show without costumes, but we practice closing and opening the curtain in between each one. And we're kind of giving feedback like, oh, you're like off the stage, make sure that you scoot in. So it's just like little things.
I felt pretty good about it. It was a little rough. That was our first time kind of running all those dances on stage, realizing how little time we had sort of in between each dance. So we kind of used that time to basically like test out how much time we had. And correct spacing that we weren't able to fix beforehand, but we got to leave pretty early, so Monday wasn't as tiring.
I feel like that was the easiest day. It was like a very chill day.
Me, Yana, and Desiree choreographed POW.
We didn't know we were going to choreograph a dance for Spring Show, but then we were given the great opportunity of being able to, and it was just a lot of fun being able to do something new.
Monday was full show, no costumes, which was kind of intense because just running the dances back to back is already really hard, but with curtains and spacing and all of that, that kind of is a lot.
Yes, ma'am.
The full show once, and that was actually really hard because like whenever we're practicing, yeah, we put our all into the dance, but then you have to like realize, oh, I have to put my all into every single dance that I'm in, and if your dances are back to back, it's really hard because you just like catch your breath, but you still have to look the emotion that you need to for the dance. So the first day was a bit difficult just because we've never done it like the full show.
Guys, it's like the office moment, like y'all are on camera.
Say something sussy.
Oh.
My back hurts really bad.
Wow. Yeah.
Honestly, not that bad for first day. What else?
Yeah, my like ankles hurt really bad.
I have tendonitis in the back of my knee.
Yeah.
I can feel it.
My shirt's kind of wet from the sweat, and my face is sticky.
Hair's greasy.
I'm like concerned for my hair later this week.
I'm gonna have the best shower right now.
Yeah, put my hair in twists in hopes of it staying for actual show days. But my optimism before them because sweating a lot more than I thought I would.
Yes!
Hey guys! We still have Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and I think with that, we're gonna do really good.
I agree. I think also practicing in our like costumes and actual how long we have to change and how long we have in between each dance and just running them on the stage consistently this week will be helpful. We still have the rest of the week. It's okay. And adrenaline does crazy things. So,
that adrenaline is what's gonna keep me going.
Adrenaline goes crazy.
Day we did the first act with costumes, and that was also difficult because we haven't done it in costumes before, but doing it in costumes allows us to get a feel of what it's going to be like in the actual show, like how fast we have to change or if we need people helping us and like where we go.
My arms were really bad today, and it was really embarrassing falling on my face for every single turn, and Anna and Diana watching me because I almost fell.
I had the same issue. I couldn't turn. I would just hold there in my releve, waiting to turn, and I wasn't turning.
Agreed.
Ditto. And then and then they'd be like, maybe hold all that turn. I'd be like, yes, ma'am.
When you're in the air, don't move. I saw your toes wiggle, and I'm hold it. Don't show what's going on. But don't hurt yourself. Okay. Reese, you have specialty part. I can't find you. Oh, there you go. You cut off, you do a tilt and then you go into something else. Right?
Anna and Diana being there was probably the one thing that helped spring show run as amazingly as it did, because when they came, they gave us really good constructive criticism, and it really helped us because it gave us specific points to work on, and they know us and they know our dancing style and they know almost every person's name, and so they were able to give individual critiques, and it helped the whole rest of the week run really smoothly.
I'm gonna be in the way no matter what. I'm gonna stand right here.
We'll still come out of that back curtain, but we'll do a little curve up.
Yes, sir.
So, are you facing? Okay, I love Emma Wright. We used to actually take ballet together, and I hated that class because no one talked to me. But Emma Wright and I became really close in that ballet class. And I was so excited when she made Pacesetters and could finally do it. And I have just loved watching her as a head squad leader.
Because we all choreographed it together and we all have our cute little lantern, and they're my favorite people in the whole world.
Okay.
And I love watching them.
Back up and say, I'm in this many dances.
Oh.
This is my favorite.
And she's literally an amazing officer. Oh my gosh. She was an amazing squad leader too, but she's amazing on leadership. I literally love her so much. She's so gentle with her voice, and she's so kind, and I just love that about her. The squad leaders the most, because I've just been with them the whole year. Those are my little sidekicks, and then they're just leaving. Are you kidding me? But it's okay, I guess it's whatever.
I realized we have to go through senior presentation and we have to go through the whole bowing thing. That takes forever.
I told Abigail to talk into the microphone, and she leaned into my body. It looked so funny on the camera. She leaned into my body and was like, hi,
or something like that. It was so funny. We watched that over and over again.
Have a conversation.
Get close to the mic.
Hi.
I low-key had a meltdown 5 minutes ago, trying to keep the energy up.
Spring show is gonna be absolutely spectacular. We have the best directors in the whole world, and it's literally gonna be so amazing.
Including Mrs. Michelle Rogers, who
Queen
we love
Raji.
So much. She's actually standing
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, she happens to be right there. She is so amazing. We love everything
I wish
she
I could grab the
us.
Camera and be like,
look at her.
Off that way, and y'all can just go in through these two small curtains right there. Like, it's okay. Yeah.
Today we did second act, so we got to do closer for the first time in full uniform, which is obviously a lot different because wearing your hat and belt, it's a totally different experience kicking in those, especially a 6 minute long kick routine. But luckily, everyone worked really hard, so we only did it once, which is really nice. I don't think that's ever happened. Since I've been on the team, we've never gotten to do closer just once that night, but we got to. So that's
is probably senior. I just like dancing with everyone, and I like that it's not a super like demanding dance, but I love that dance a lot, and I love dancing with the seniors so much.
You're okay.
Everything's starting to come together. At first, like y'all know, I was a little iffy, but now everyone's putting energy in it and we get lights tomorrow, so that's really exciting, and I'm hoping everything goes well.
Was second act with costumes. That was where things started to go downhill for me because I had 10 quick changes. But it was fun. I got through it.
She's a four-year member who served as squad leader her junior year and currently is a lieutenant. Did you stop and face the front?
Did you record me crying?
Yes.
Why would you do that?
Alexa will be attending Texas Christian University in the fall, and she will major in nursing. Miss Alexa Hernandez.
So I did start crying during senior presentations. I'm just a very emotional person. And then whenever they called Desiree's name, I was like, oh my gosh, Desiree. And then I was like, oh my gosh, all the seniors. Like, this is our last time doing spring show together. Like, we're probably... Like, when are we gonna see each other again? Like, we have to plan that. And, like, we're all gonna be busy. And, like, Rogers is leaving. And so when we come back, like, nothing's gonna be the same. So, like, this is the last year that things are gonna be how they are. And it just made me really sad. And so I started crying.
Thursday. Full act. Costumes. That's when we had lights come, which was super exciting. Running the dance with lights for the first time is like crazy experience because it starts to like really hit you that we're about to perform this in front of a bunch of people the next day. And you also get a real taste of, you know, what you're going to be doing on show.
I'm tired already, and I've danced twice. And I come off stage, like, especially in the second act, because I have 10 dances out of the 15 in the second act, or 16, 15 or 16. I go like this, and people take clothes off of me and put new ones on me.
My favorite moment was when it would be, like, in between dances during spring show night, and, like, all the seniors would be yelling. They'd be like, oh, my gosh, like, I need help with this, and da-da-da. I remember Kendall was unzipping and zipping so many people. I thought it was the funniest thing ever.
My montage. I mean, not the second one, because the other ones are coming out.
Thank you, Kendall. Either.
A flower, and I don't know how to do it.
Oh, sorry.
So it's like it starts out right here, and then I just snatch it off. Got this. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh, my leaf just came off.
It feels so close.
I'll do better.
Me and Kendall are very funny. What we did, what did Kendall and I do? We talked to the camera a lot.
Eva.
OT, this top is from Storage Closet. Probably, it's giving Target, Michaels.
Do you want me to zip you up?
Circa 2009.
Yes, please.
I think we just kind of talked about how spring show was going. I gave a lot of time updates. I do remember that. And we kind of just like messed around with the camera. So it was fun.
Like, I think they're slightly, like, it's like different, like, okay. Material or whatever, but
okay.
It's just that. I've been going this whole week without a Twyla to turn on, so.
Thursday was the worst of them all because we ran the whole show. But we didn't have to do closer at the end, and that was the best part.
We're gonna do just presentation, and then we're gonna pretend like I did kick. So tomorrow night, it better look fabulous.
Thursday was rough. Yeah, because we had to do it a bunch, and we stayed there a lot later than we had the rest of the week. But I don't regret having to stay late Thursday, ironically enough, because at that point, like, the show was the next day, and we were already going to have a lot of adrenaline for the show anyways. So not that being tired didn't matter, but it was, like, going into the last day of the week, and we were already going to have adrenaline for the show, so we didn't have any more practices. So I think staying late only on Thursday just helped the overall tech week experience instead of staying late like every single day.
I love dancing, but it's very stressful learning the dances and stuff like that. I think I've gained a lot of skills from dance, and I think I'll be able to use those in everyday life.
So yeah, I'm just gonna focus on using those.
Kind of sad because I like performing. And I don't think I ever realized I like performing so much until this year, whenever I was gonna stop. But it's okay because I'll still like take side dance classes or learn combos and stuff, and that's still fun, so it's okay.
I am not dancing in college because I just need like a break from the whole team thing. Like I don't want to stress as much as I did in high school. Yeah, that's
it. Will you go back to dancing after a break?
I might. Well, depending. I know I'm going to miss it, but I'm thinking about going into maybe sophomore, junior year. But as of now, I'm not.
I feel a little sad, but mostly excited just to know that I'm free to do whatever I want and explore the world now. I think I'll take dance classes in college, but I don't want to be on a team just because I've been on a team for 6 years. I'm kind of ready to take a break and maybe just do some classes.
Now that my high school dance experience is over, I'm sad. Like, I've been coming to practice because we have to, but we're not dancing. And I'm just sad. That's the only word I can think of. I'm just sad. I wish it wasn't over.
I'm a little sad, but I feel more at peace now that spring show is done. And it's kind of getting closer to the end, but it's kind of sad seeing all the new team and like all of like the new leadership and all that stuff. It's kind of, it makes you feel old.
I'm content at where I'm at. It's sad because I've been dancing since I was 2.5, but this experience has been so fun. So the way it's ended, I couldn't have been happier.
It's so sad. I didn't think I was gonna be this sad because when I joined Pacesetters, I didn't expect to get like this attached to it. But it's like really sad that it's all come to an end, but I'm also really happy for all the time I got with everyone.
Yeah. Very happy to be a senior and to be graduating very soon, I think in like 3 weeks. But I am also extremely sad because I wouldn't say I'm sad. I would say that I'm scared because it's going to be a whole new adventure for me. But overall, I'm very happy to start a new chapter of my life.
This is class of 2022 signing out.